In this video, I'll be introducing you to the PI interface for OPC DA. I'll explain how data collection works, I'll give some architecture recommendations, and finally, I'll enumerate the different steps that you need to accomplish to install and configure your very own PI interface for OPC DA. The PI interface for OPC DA is used to collect data from an OPC DA server. But in order to understand what an OPC DA server is, we first need to understand what OPC DA means. OPC stands for OLI for process control. DA stands for data access. So OPC DA is a standard to communicate data across automation systems. So let's take a step back. Here we have a bunch of different vendors with different automation systems. These systems are speaking different languages. And the PI system also speaks its own language. So these languages need to be translated. People in the automation industry came up with the OPC standard. So this is a standard way to expose data on these systems and a standard way of collecting data on these systems. So it's basically a standard that was created to facilitate data sharing. How does data sharing actually work using the OPC DA standard? Well, first we have our data source. And this data source is connected to an OPC DA server. This OPC DA server is collecting data off the data source and exposing it using the OPC DA standard. And it's making it available to different applications. These applications are called OPC DA clients. So these are applications whose job it is to translate the data from the OPC DA standard into whatever protocol is needed for their data sync. So basically, on the PI system, the OPC DA client is the PI interface for OPC DA, and the data sync is the PI data archive. So the OPC DA server, once again, is translating the data from the data source, and the PI interface for OPC DA is translating the data from the OPC DA server for the PI data archive to be able to accept it. And once the data reaches the PI data archive, it can then be reached by various different PI clients. So at this point, you might be wondering, where do I install these different components? Well, you have a couple different options, but what we recommend is to install the OPC DA server and the PI interface for OPC DA on the same node. This greatly facilitates the installation process, and it also reduces the points of failure, since both of these are on the same node. However, it is possible to install the OPC DA server and the PI interface for OPC DA on different nodes. However, this will require an additional step of configuring DCOM security. So this is important to keep in mind. So those of you who are a bit more familiar with the PI interface for OPC DA might recall that we also have the PI interface for OPC HDA and might be wondering why you would use the PI interface for OPC HDA or the PI interface for OPC DA. Well, these are simply different protocols or different standards for the OPC standards. So as we know, DA stands for data access, whereas HDA stands for historical data access. So an OPC server might be either OPC DA or OPC HDA compliant. So OPC DA means that the OPC server is going to be getting real-time data, so data that's going to be updating on a periodic basis, whereas an OPC HDA server would have a bunch of historical or archived data, and the OPC HDA client would be getting all this data at once and sending it to its data sync. The quick answer might be, well, if your OPC server is OPC DA compliant, then you would use the PI interface for OPC DA, and if your OPC server is OPC HDA compliant, then you would use the PI interface for OPC HDA. But a lot of OPC servers can actually be used for both OPC DA and OPC HDA. So a better answer would be, it depends what kind of data you want to collect. If you want to collect real-time data, so data that's going to be updating periodically, then you'll want to use the PI interface for OPC DA. Alright, so next question. Let's say we have a bunch of different OPC DA servers. We have multiple OPC DA servers. Do we need to install the Pine Interface for OPC DA multiple times? Well, no. All we need is a single Pine Interface for OPC DA installation, and we need to configure multiple instances of the Pine Interface for OPC DA. To do that, we need the Pine Interface configuration utility. And even if you only have a single OPC DA server, you'll need the Pine Interface configuration utility, since this is the GUI that's used to create instances of the Pine Interface for OPC DA, and to configure them, and also to maintain them. So you will need to install both of these components. Okay, so we've gone over all of the basics. Now, what are the steps that we're going to need to go through? So the first step is going to be to install the Pine Interface for OPC DA and the Pine Interface configuration utility. Next, we're going to need to make sure that our OPC server has a good status and it has data updating. And we'll do this using the PyOPC client tool, which is installed when you install the Pine Interface for OPC DA. Next, we'll want to configure a new instance of the Pine Interface for OPC DA using the Py Interface Configuration utility. Then, we'll want to create Py points to collect data from the OPC server. And finally, once we've done all that, we need to make sure to configure buffering with the Py buffer subsystem to make sure that if ever our Py Interface for OPC DA loses its connection with the Py data archive, it'll be able to continue collecting data and buffer this data. So in the upcoming playlist, I'll be showing you how to complete all the steps required to start collecting data from an OPC server. And once you've done that, you can check out our PyBuffer subsystem playlist in order to learn how to configure buffering.